All right, I think this is Councilman Mercer, Economic Development Bylaws.
May I appreciate the opportunity, and I regret that I have to bring this item to you this evening, but this committee has met on a couple of occasions, and at our last meeting, the county commissioners that were present indicated that they didn't want to proceed any further until they got some indication as to where the city was headed with this project. And I sent to all of you all an email several weeks ago outlining the options that had been discussed, and I sent them to you again, I think Friday, and told you that they would be used in our discussion this evening. What it amounts to at the present time is that the Economic Development Board, you want to take your time?
If you don't mind, thank you for noticing that. We need some more time if we're going to continue.
You need an hour?
No. No, we don't need an hour.
We've got a closed session.
I know.
Mr. Mayor, I make a motion that we give them 30 minutes.
Okay.
Second.
Going to 8 o'clock, okay. All those in favor, please indicate by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed will like sign. We'll try.
All right. Would like also to note there's a severe thunderstorm warning, and I'm sitting here looking at the radar, and we should get some really, really bad storms in the next 10 minutes.
In other words, you're telling me to be quick.
Staff may be leaving to take care of some issues. I'm sorry.
You've already scared Christie out. As a quick review, the current Economic Development Board consists of six members from the county, 3 members from this council, and then a representative from any municipality within the county that pays a fee of $6 and some few cents per capita for a position on that board. In order for us to have our 3 seats, that we are supposed to be paying 35% of the annual budget, the annual operating budget of the commission. The county is paying 65%. We have historically been, the split has been approximately 190 and 90 for a total budget of $280,000. In the past, as all of you all know, anytime there's been a project, the EDC director or someone has come to the city and said, we've got a project that needs your participation. We've done that at least twice this year. When we look at the current configuration, the count is $190,000 for approximately 45,000 county residents, is a little over $4 a person. The city with 10,000 people has put it in $90,000, or an additional $9 per person. So as a city resident paying both city and county taxes, we're contributing about $13.50 to economic development in the county. The municipalities are putting in 6 and 4, or normally 10. So in essence, the city residents are paying a larger per capita share than any of the other residents in the county. Now, when we got to the discussion of revising the bylaws, I made these points, and I said, I don't think that the city council should pay, or the cities of Washington should pay a larger share than anyone else in the county. And my recommendation was that the county be the sole funding agency for the Economic Development Commission, and that city residents and other municipality residents would pay through their county taxes. The county manager pointed out that by statute, an economic development board was limited to 9 members. And so we had a couple of options. One, that the board be consist of 9 members, 2 at large from the county, and 1 from each of the cities and municipalities, for a total of 9 members. The second option was that the commission be comprised of 9 members, 3 at large from the county, and 1 each from the municipalities of Aurora, Bath, Chalkwood, Patagonia, Washington, Washington Park. And the third option was that there be 9 members, 2 at large members from the county, 1 member from the city, and 1 from each of the municipalities. Those are basically, there's a little difference in, but essentially each municipality is going to get a representative. The county is going to appoint at large. And then the fourth option was to leave it with 9 members, 1 from each of the townships, not the towns, but the township, because there are 6 townships in the county, and 3 individuals with proven or demonstrated interest in economic development. And then option number 5 would be to leave it just like it is. At this point, the next question comes up is what happens to funding? Well, if the county becomes, if you adopt options 1, 2, or 3, and the county becomes the primary funding agency, then the city does not have a direct obligation to fund the activities of the EDC on an annual basis, only as an outside agency, and they come to this board just like any other outside agency would at each budget session. We would not be obligated to pay a fixed percentage of some budget over which we have no control. The present configuration says that that budget should be presented to this board for review, but it gives us no veto authority. It's my recommendation to this, and excuse me, the other was, of course, that that we continue to operate in the same manner that we have, and we continue to split the operating budget on a 65-35, and it's the municipality putting in a small one. The county commissioners have, we don't need to proceed with this to the county commissioners until we know what the city's going to do. They asked me to bring it to you tonight and for your discussion and a vote as to what we would like to do. Now, it is my recommendation to this board that we adopt option number 1 or 4 or 3, which says that the county will become the funding agency, and that there be representatives from the county on an at-large basis, and that the townships each have a representative, giving you a total board of 9, and that there be no specified contribution annually from this board other than what might be requested as a request from an outside agency, which we would consider each year in our budget discussions.
And I would add to that that we leave our current budget allocation for economic development intact. That way we have funds set aside that if we are called upon and we are not walking away from economic development, we're just not funding it the way we used to. The major flaw, as Councilman Mercer pointed out, in our old method was we funded and then we were called upon above and beyond. We didn't have those funds in the budget or any allocation ready for those funds, right? I personally like the 6 townships and the 3 at-large appointments.
No money
allocated for direct participation, but left in the line item.
Yeah, in other words, we'd have an economic development line item just like we have this year.
Yeah.
Of whatever we want to put in. And if the EDC board wants to come to this council during our budget presentation and request an amount of money, then we would have the opportunity to discuss that amount and say, what are you going to use it for? And say yay or nay, just like we do for any other outside agency.
Okay, Councilman, what do you need to take back to them? Do you need a...
I would like to have a vote.
Okay.
That says we endorse option number...
Is that number 3?
3, I believe it is.
You need that tonight?
You really need that tonight?
No, excuse me. Option four, which is a township option.
Option four.
So if we do it that way, in essence, we're going to begin out the EDC business of funding.
No. That's my point. We will leave our economic development allocation in our budget and use those funds. For instance, we just committed no more than $30,000 to a retail recruitment and retention strategy. So we're staying in the economic development business. We're just not going to fund the economic development budget at the county level. One of the things that Councilman Mercer talked about that I think needs clarification is the current trend or thought is to make that a county position, reporting to the county manager. So there are obviously some complications with the city funding a county position, or even in part funding that. The other thing is, if we keep doing it the way we're doing it, city residents pay a disproportionate greater amount than just we do as county residents, because everybody in the city is a county resident anyway. So we're still funded per capita. We're still committing to EDC. We're just not going to pay for that salary position. Is that fair?
That's right.
Okay. In other words, we're paying twice.
Under the current situation, we're paying twice.
But and we do it that way, that means will we have any say-so about whatever that's coming for the table before the county commission?
You'd have one representative.
Not under that. If you do the township, it would be one from Washington Township. It would not necessarily be a member of this council.
No, that's what I'm saying. We would have one appointee.
Right.
Yeah. We have three appointees now. They're not three members of this council. They're three appointees from here.
So right now, I think Councilman Mercer is on that.
Yeah, and I've served on it before.
Point of clarification, and City Attorney just asked this of me, and I guess I ask it of Councilman Mercer. Who would appoint that representative from the township?
The county commissioners.
And so if the county commission appoints someone for the township, and if we're not playing the way they want us to play, then it's almost ironic that we may not even get the position to sit on or have a representation from this council to sit on that board.
It's possible.
Councilman Moultrie, what you would find is the EDC board then would be appointed just like a number of the other county boards are, by county commissioners, with representatives from a township or however, and they would appoint all the members. And it would not necessarily, there would be no direct representation of the city council unless they chose to appoint a member from the city council.
Thoughts? Okay, how about doing that?
Councilman Mercer, you want to make the motion for item number four?
If you would like, Mr. Mayor, I'd make a motion that the city endorse option number four for the membership of the, as proposed in the rewrite of the county EDC bylaws.
Would you take the friendly amendment like the mayor mentioned about keeping the money that we set aside in the budget allocate
that? That basically has nothing to do with the bylaw right.
Okay.
Right. I think that what the mayor suggested, obviously, is that as a group, when we get to the budget session, we can put a economic development line item in, and then that money is going to be used for whatever we choose during that budget year.
Okay. I'll say.
All right, discussion. All those in favor, please indicate by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, with like sign.
Aye.
Okay. All right. Anything else?
Now, I would just point out that it, by adopting that option, it basically limits the county to the adoption of option number three for funding, which says that the county will review and consider an annual operating budget request from the commission, including so forth and so on. And that, by adoption, if they ultimately adopt option four, they have to adopt option three.
All right, we've got 17 minutes, and we need to go to closed session.
I have that.